สิงคโปร์
สวัสดีค่ะ Good afternoon from Thailand. Let me briefly introduce myself. My name is Supanit Thien Sing. I'm a Senior Manager's Business Development of Meeting and Incentive Department of Thailand Convention and Exhibition Bureau, or TCEB. Thank you very much for giving Thailand an opportunity to be a place for your business event. Today, I would like to update you the latest travel situation and TCEB initiative, as well as support for business event to Thailand.Next, I would like to share the presentation. First of all, on behalf of TCEB, I would like to take this opportunity to express my deep appreciation to the government and all medical and healthcare professionals around the world for their hard work and dedication, risking their life to protect us and our well-being.Since the outbreak, Thai government has exercised very strict and effective health and hygiene measures, focusing on quick detection, medication, and patient management, and enforced the self-protection mechanism to minimize the effect of the outbreak within the countries. All state groups pays off. Today, World Health Organization or WHO has singled out Thailand as an excellent example in fighting the coronavirus.We can point out that Thailand's success was the result of the country's commitment to invest in its public health infrastructures, pointing out its network of more than a million village health volunteers who play a critical role in the response to the pandemic. Thailand is also among the top 5 countries in GCI's Global COVID-19 Recovery Index. WHO has chosen Thailand and New Zealand.For a film documentary on the successful models for handling and curbing COVID-19. Thailand has also remained in the top ranking of the best country to start business since 2019, despite the challenging economic situation worldwide. The rankings are based on the global awareness surveys and ranking countries based on the ratings of nearly 6,000 business decision makers.Please allow me to update you on our vaccine situation. We could be a sign for the safe travel rebound that the Thai Government of Public Health, AstraZeneca, Siam Bioscience, and SCG announced their intent to manufacture the University of Oxford potential COVID-19 vaccine in Thailand. The vaccine developed by the university.We use the factory of Siam Bioscience in Thailand as a production base for the ASEAN region. According to the Siam Bioscience, the first batch of vaccine could be available in the first half of 2021 or around June, with the expected technology transfer from AstraZeneca and following Thai FDA regulatory approval. In addition to producing the vaccine for domestic needs,Siam Bioscience Group will also be making vaccines for ASEAN countries. As such, the Ministry of Public Health has signed up to join COVAX, a global initiative involving over 20 vaccine developers from all over the world to ensure that all demand can be met. When it's come to the mice, since the beginning of this year, TCEB made a conscious decision to operate in crisis mode.And immediately came up with 3R strategy as our direction in shoring up the MICE sectors. The first R is a response plan activated since February. We set up MICE COVID info centers, we relaxed support criteria, and provided additional relief campaign to all events this year. We provided hygiene fund to revenues, special fund to activate domestic MICE.We also established a virtual meeting space and online platform for webinar and virtual events and e-learning for public use. We have a medium-term recovery and 3-year restoration framework and plan. We focus on two dimensions. One is a government policy, not only to push my recovery as a national plan, but also working on the taxation regime visa facilitation, logistic arrangement, and etc. The other dimension is the collaboration with the private sector. TCEP and industry associations have already been working closely together to create new MICE products and services. We have new subvention program to facilitate international events, to serve new normal, and to drive the whole MICE ecosystem. Let's take a look at what we have implemented at each stage to keep business alive and to plan for safer business events to Thailand. Responding to online technology, we launched the virtual meeting space or VMS to provide webinar for organizers to hold online meetings and launch virtual expo offline to online for exhibition so that they can launch product online and conduct transaction on the online platform. As of now, more than 52 events have applied to use our online platform. Our key or highlight product is My Venue Hygiene Guideline, which is a result of TCEP collaboration with our key stakeholder associations. This guideline was presented to the government and the Ministry of Public Health to ensure that MICE in Thailand can be run without posing health risks, and they are in line with the government's board framework. The achievement is finally made. The Ministries of Public Health finally approved this guideline, which will serve as a new normal standard operating procedure to ensure that hygiene and safety for all MICE events. So now, I'm happy to report that all MICE events in Thailand are fully open and must adhere to the new normal SOP. TCEP has also set up TCEP COVID-19 information centers to serve as a communication center during this critical period. The center will monitor, compile, examine, and assess the information, especially the impact of the disease on MICE industry, and procedures produce the recommendation for the industry. The second task of the center is to update the situation, especially government rules and regulation and announcements, and publicize them to the industry so that they can keep abreast of the development that may impact their business and plans. As a health safety is the primary concern in organizing events, we set up fund under the project of COVID-19 free meeting to subsidize venues in installing tools, educating staff, and setting up health protocol. As of now, more than 200 venues across Thailand have applied for this project. We also lower an expanded area of support for business events planning their trip to Thailand very soon. One of the support campaigns is Ease Up, which is the result of our latest incentive meeting, People Focus, or I Am People Focus campaign. The campaign was initiated from our belief that people matter. We believe in the power of people and compassion. When collaborating with TCEP, we focus on you and will support your event success. That's why we launched a new meeting and incentive campaign called I Am People Focus, targeting meeting and incentive people and the business event community because everyone matters. This campaign is a collaborative effort between TCEP and private sector to offer new non-subvention program because we believe that business events are about sharing experiences, and we believe in power of responsible gathering. The campaign is underpinned by Ease Up financial grants to support your return to Thailand. Ease Up is an initial financial support of more than $500,000 from TCEP and an equivalent value in the complementary products and services from participating partner. This special grant is available for corporate meeting and or incentive group holding their events in Thailand within 30th of June 2021, of course with term and condition applied. TCEP will offer you a financial subsidy to a group for a meeting package or dining experience, and in addition to TCEP support, hotels, venues, and DMC members of TICA in Thailand have joined hands in creating Ease Up with an extra benefits. As of now, there are 64 partners comprising of 8 DMCs and 56 hotels joining this special campaign. Some of our campaign partners are also exhibiting at ITCMA this year. Please explore for more deals and support at our Thailand Pavilion. If you would like to contact us to learn more about EaseUp, the brochure is available for download from this session. And if you would like to discuss more in detail, please contact TCEB at mi@tceb.or.th. When it comes to Thailand travel situation, please let me update you that Thailand has opened for long stay visitors under the Special Tourist Visa or STV. At the moment, we have implemented the first phase for STV from countries with the lower COVID-19 infection rates. The visa is valid for 90 days and can be extended twice for a further of 90 days in each time. All visitors are required to undergo a 14-day quarantine in alternative state quarantine or alternative local state quarantine. However, Thailand is evaluating the first phase outcome and considering the second phase, which is to have 7-day quarantine in a hotel room and another 7-day quarantine in a hotel. And the third phase will be followed by removing quarantine. But visitors are still required to take a test of the quick COVID-19 at the immigration. Under the first phase of STV, we have welcomed 4 groups from China and Scandinavian countries since October. There are more than 1,600 people requesting to enter to Thailand under the current STV. As you can see, Phuket is one of the most popular MICE destinations in Thailand, has resumed 4 international semi-commercial flights weekly operated by Emirates and Qatar Airways. More semi-commercial flights from all over the world are resuming their routes back to Thailand. This information is a positive indication that Thailand is getting ready for your return. TCEB, together with all Thai MICE industry, is working very hard to establish a safe environment for all MICE travelers to come back safely and securely. Hygiene measures and SOP are put in place, prompted and prepared for your next journey to Thailand. On behalf of the Thai government, thank you for trusting us to be your next destination for business events. We will keep on working, connecting, and engaging with you until the day we meet again in Thailand. Before I go, I am pleased to present a video in hopes of sparking creativity and innovation by freeing the mind. I hope that the breathtaking visuals of Thailand free your mind now and until the time we meet again. Thank you very much at Khop Khun Kha.
Free your mind in Thailand. The beaches in Thailand created some really special memories for me. I think in the mornings when you open the windows and you have that beautiful view, you're just met with paradise. You know, the sand rolls into the ocean, rolls into the sky, and it's just the most relaxing start to the day. You take the walks along the beach in the morning and you see the group doing yoga. If you're early enough, you catch the sunrise, and I think it really does set the tone for the rest of the day. The beachscapes also delivered some really warm memories for me. We participated in some beach regeneration activities, and participating in that and working with the locals to really restore their pristine beaches was really special, and you just saw the huge smiles on the kids' faces. It just created such a good memory. And then in the evenings, the beach was the perfect backdrop for sunset drinks. We'd have cocktails on the beach bars in Koh Samui. And it also created a great gateway for the sunset cruises, and we'd look back over the beach landscape. And in the evenings, we'd have the group dining experiences on the beach where you had your shoes off, you were eating great food, and the fire twirlers would create a spectacle on the water's edge. You really can free your mind in Thailand.
I can free my mind only in Thailand. There is a plethora of wellness options. Delegates can center their minds by giving alms in the morning, followed by a core-centric meditation class. A world-renowned Thai spa in the afternoon helps rejuvenate the mind, body, and soul, followed by a sumptuous dinner in the city. Come, free your mind only in Thailand.
Free my mind in Thailand. Do you know why I say so? Well, here's why. I have visited Thailand several times, and each time I discover a new Thailand waiting for me. If you believe the city outside, you can still experience the untouched nature and the deep trace of eternal history. For my planners, various hotels and venues in the majestic nature can accommodate your groups and luxury at ease. The fresh air and breathtaking views of the mountain range motivates you to disconnect from everyday tech life and reconnect more with inner self. Also, it is a perfect place for CSR activities. More and more, several companies are putting their eyes on CSR work in Thailand. They can experience a lifestyle that is in complete harmony with nature, interacting with people while paying respect to the local culture. That's why I select Thailand top of my list. So, come see yourself and free your mind in Thailand.
Okay, so there are few questions that's asking about the border reopen for whether's many which countries that the border reopen. Now the border is open for the STV special tourist visa that you can get in touch with the Thai embassy in the countries and apply for the STV visa. Then we have a guideline that what you have to do to apply for the STV. So the Thai embassy in its destination can give you the exact information. And some asking about the first batch of the vaccine that will be available. So we're trying and working really hard with the government, and I just mentioned through my presentation with the University of the Upford that the vaccine should be available next year. We hope that the first batch will be available by June 2021.
Okay.
And of course, if the the border is already open and the first phase of the quarantine is lifted, we would love to do a fam trip to Thailand, of course, with the media fam and our customer to visit Thailand and, you know, experience Thailand by themselves. And then thank you very much for everyone, everyone for asking the question to Thailand. And if you have any inquiry, please feel free to contact us via email at mi@tceb.or.th. Regarding the update, I can send you the information via email later. If you please contact us via email that I just mentioned, I can send you the information, the updated information. STV. We have the guideline for the STV that is we post on the embassy, Thai embassy and government website. So at first, you need to contact the Thai embassy for the certificate of enter to Thailand. And then they will have a protocol and document that you need to submit to get the COE. And of course, you need to have a test within 72 hours before you get on the plane. And when you arrive and enter to Thailand, they will have a procedures that you need to quarantine. The first phase is 14 days at the ASQ or ALSQ. Okay. We do have a tracking application available that you need to download before entering to Thailand. And all the information can be downloaded from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs website. So do you have any more questions? So please feel free to contact me at the email mi@tceb.or.th if you require further information or any support from TCEB. Thank you very much and ขอบคุณค่ะ. Good job.